Hi, this is Rick Eymer with the Palo Alto Weekly, and we're here today with Claire Pisani. She's a senior at Castilleja with the water polo team. She's our Athlete of the Week after she helped the Gators win the league title for our fifth time in a row. She's never been on a team that's lost in the PAL in her 4 years, so it's quite an achievement. She, of course, led the team in scoring for most of the way. And I'd like to start there, just talk about the tournament a little bit and how you guys, kind of played through it and how you saw it.
Yeah, I mean, it's like you said, it's been amazing these past 4 years, like playing with my team. And I think, we always expect to come out really strong in PALs and sort of try to keep it up and keep that momentum going towards CCS. We're always like looking towards CCS and sort of like trying to keep up the energy throughout PALs. So, yeah.
Right, and seeded number 8 in the CCS, which means, in the rankings currently, you're one of the top 8 teams in the CCS. Right. Obviously, you have to play the number 1 team in the CCS to start, but, I'm sure you're up for the challenge, and, just getting this far has got to be, open division is kind of a thing.
Yeah, no, exactly. Like, we've, starting last year, we were in open division too, and we've been talking about it, and, it might have been nice to, be top in division 2, but, in the end, these are closer games, better games, and we just really enjoy challenging ourselves and seeing if we can do our best. And yeah, we're really looking forward to playing St. Francis and Leland and just coming out really hard.
Right. Now, Castilleja is also a Division 5 school, and they're up against these Division 2 and 1 schools, so that says something about how good the program is. And of course, the program is led by an Olympian and a gold medalist at that. Can you talk about her a little bit? What kind of an impact Brenda's made?
I mean, Brenda's amazing. She's not just as a coach, but as a person too. She works here at Castilleja too with sort of social equity and stuff. And she's just a really inspiring person to be around all the time, regardless of whether it's definitely in the pool too, right? She knows what she's talking about. She's the best of the best. And, she's has a way of inspiring us and making us work our hardest and at the same time encouraging us and not getting down on us, which is really cool and something really unique, I think, in coaches. She has a really high intensity, but is also really great at inspiring us. And yeah, she's just a really awesome person to be around, regardless of coaching or not. Yeah.
Yeah, obviously very good, and went to Stanford, of course, 4-time All-American, all that great stuff. Before we were setting up, this is close to Halloween when we're filming this, we were talking a little bit about an experiment that the chemistry club did out just at the end of school, and I'd like you to talk about that and how it went and what happened.
Yeah, it was really amazing. I lead this club called Blast with my friend Katie, and inspired by Halloween, we basically exploded some pumpkins, and the idea is to create this gas inside the pumpkins and ignite it and have that sort of pop out the face of the pumpkin. But it turned into a bigger explosion, which was really exciting and fun. Yeah.
And of course, you had quite a crowd out here watching and getting a lot of attention, I guess.
Yeah, it's really awesome because I think we just really try to inspire other people to be as passionate about chemistry and science in general as we are. So it's really cool to get the younger girls into it too. Yeah.
Yeah, I thought just thought that was interesting. We had to bring that one up. And getting back to water polo, of course, half your career in high school, but the other half has been with the Stanford Water Polo Club. Some excellent programs, and kind of just talk about how your history there has gone.
Yeah, I mean, I've really enjoyed Stanford too, and some of my best friends are from Stanford and from Castilleja, Madison Lewis, current senior. She's really awesome, one of my best friends. People too, Georgia Lewis, who was our goalie last year, who's at Bucknell now. We're just really awesome friends and really dear friends and teammates, and I've really felt welcomed, and just we've had a great time. It's definitely a different level of intensity for club than with school, but I feel really prepared going between the two, so yeah.
Right, and I know that, club, you're practicing more often and in higher levels and with coaches that have been at the USA national program level, so there's no, there's obviously no comparison. Poor Brenda, she has to be stuck with Menlo Park when she does that stuff.
Yeah. And she coaches. No, I mean, she loves working with the Belhaven girls, and yeah, that's I know it's a little less intense, but she really loves that. Yeah.
Oh, sure. Well, I mean, I know where she's coming from. She's her upbringing is an amazing thing in itself. So it's Yeah, quite a life. But now, so anyway, moving forward, you have the CCS coming up. Now, I guess the goal would be just to make the NorCals, but of course that would be very difficult. And you know, even if you lose this game and don't go to NorCals, you still should consider yourselves better than anybody that wins a number of Division I and Division II, tournaments. How does that work in as far as your attitudes?
I mean, I think, like, just like you said, we at the end of the day, like, we would really love to win, but either way, like, we're going to try to give Leland and St. Francis a run for their money and, like, just really, like, stick it to them. Like, we try to be really passionate about athletics here at Castilleja, and especially the water polo team. Like, we love, like, bringing, like, pride for our school and sort of, like, showing up and repping Castilleja, and I think that's what we're going to try to come out and do. Yeah,
and I was here for your senior night or day or whatever it was, and I was impressed just because of the way you guys responded to what the other gals did, and I thought that was pretty cool. I think that talks about the passion and everything. I mean, is that a ceremony that's repeated itself, or is that something special?
Yeah, no, I mean, senior night is definitely like one of like the really special night of each season. But yeah, we've been trying to feed off that energy, and I think that really showed in our PAL win against Menlo, the same team we played on our senior night. And going into that, we were just like, yeah, we got to keep up that energy from senior night and just really come out and like honor each other, honor the seniors, and just like get out there. And like it's our last, like my last league game ever, and I'm really proud of how it went. Yeah.
So we've been talking to Claire Pisani. She's our Athlete of the Week this week, and congratulations.
Thank you so much.
And if you want to find out about next week's Athlete of the Week, please hit that subscribe button down below or visit us at pasportsonline.com.